The details of a horrifying case of domestic violence are set to unfold this week in a Polk County courtroom.
Randall Moore is going on trial for kidnapping, brutal rape and murder of his wife, and the attempted murder of a Des Moines police officer. Unfortunately, here in Iowa, we are seeing more and more cases of deadly domestic abuse.
New numbers from the Iowa Coalition Against Domestic Violence show so far this year, 15 Iowans have been murdered in domestic violence crimes. It's predicted one in four women will become the victim of domestic violence at some point during her life. But tonight, one domestic violence survivor is reaching out to others from becoming a statistic. News Channel 8's Patrick Bell has her story.
Yeah, Stacey, the woman you're about to meet has lived with the trauma, the nightmare of domestic violence for years. At one point, she and her daughter were beaten so badly, she says, they both had to be hospitalized. And tonight, she hopes her story will help others survive.
I was expecting, you know, I never knew, but I was just expecting something horrible to happen, and it did. You know, it did that one particular evening.
But Anne, who's still too frightened to show her face, couldn't have possibly imagined what would happen next.
And he basically took his forearm, like you might do in football, and knock another football player down. He kept slamming me, and he'd taken our daughter by the forearm and was throwing her around the kitchen, and he'd headbutted her. I just knew that he was going to kill us.
As she dialed 911.
And he was trying to rip the phone off the wall.
Officers arrived moments later. Her then husband was taken away. She and her child were taken to the hospital.
Like my daughter said, Mom, if you finally hadn't gotten through to the police, he would have gone downstairs in the den, gotten one of his guns, and shot us both dead.
While Anne escaped domestic violence, others aren't so fortunate. In November of 2009, Therese Ann Moore was shot and killed by her estranged husband, Randall. Court records reveal she filed and was ultimately granted two protective orders. And prosecutors say Randall Moore has a history of domestic abuse. In fact, four different women also obtained protective orders against him. Survivors say the violence simply has to stop.
You don't need this. Put a stop to it. Walk away from it. And moms, don't ever let him touch your children. There's hope, and that's the point.
And Anne couldn't stress enough during our interview just how many resources there are out there for victims of domestic violence. There are hotlines, shelters, all sorts of things available. Point is, if you're in this kind of situation, get help now, she says, before it's too late.
Okay, Patrick, thank you.
You're welcome.
And as Patrick mentioned, if you or somebody you know needs help, here's a good place to start. Children and Families of Iowa Domestic Violence 24-hour hotline, the number 1-800-942-0333.
Also, Iowa's three state universities have been working to stop gender violence on their campuses. A new Center for Violence Prevention is set to open in January at the University of Northern Iowa, pending approval from the Board of Regents. The center will be funded in part by a $700,000 grant from the U.S. Department of Justice. Money also will be used to support mandatory education for first-year students at all three universities concerning sexual assault and other forms of gender violence.